morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Okay, I know it's cold outside. You can do better than that. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Welcome to Zion. Once again, we have proven that we are the Church of the Courageous, or Crazy, whichever one. Maybe it's the Courageous. Kind of put the two of them together. So glad that you've decided to brave the weather to come out this morning. And we're just going to have a great time of worship this morning as we have our program. And then also tonight, we'll come back together for a very special performance by one of our own, Darrell Nelson, and his group, the River Valley Brass. It'll be just a really cool concert with some readings and some focus on the carols. So we invite you back for that at 7 o'clock tonight. Also, next week, we have Christmas Eve, of course, is on Saturday night. We'll be having our Christmas Eve service at 4 o'clock. So we invite you to come for that next week. And that'll be also kind of our time of worship. We will not be having a Christmas Day service. We want to reserve that for you to be able to spend some time with your families. So Christmas Eve Day, 4 o'clock, we'll be coming here just for, again, a time of worship and celebrating the birth of our Savior. Oh, by the way, I should probably introduce myself. I'm Pastor Mike, for those of you that don't know, or for those of you that don't recognize me anymore with all the facial hair, which will be coming back. So just glad that you're with us. If you are a visitor, we invite you to fill out the white visitor card in front of you, just so we can have a record of your attendance. One other thing, just kind of want to share with you a little bit a God story. I think, you know, our sermon series for Advent is that we least expect that God shows up. And I want to just kind of, I think it's important for us to realize that God does that in so many different ways. Trish and I had that experience yesterday, as a matter of fact. We decided to take, we haven't had a chance to go Christmas shopping, and you guys know how the schedule goes and stuff. So we decided to sneak down to Bloomington and grab a hotel Friday afternoon and shop at the Mega Mall all day Saturday, which is one of my all-time favorite things to do. No, maybe not. There's probably more things I'd rather do. But I was in great company. So we spent the day shopping, and we went out, and I got in the car and turned the switch on the car. Absolutely nothing. Battery is completely dead. It's like, oh, great, now what are we going to do? And so Trish went in, and she talked to the security people, and they said, well, we don't jump cars anymore because of insurance, but gave me the gave us a number for a tow truck company that would come out in about a half hour and charge me $60 to start the car. All right, well, I don't know if I have road insurance on my car insurance or not. So I called the insurance company thinking, well, maybe they can come out, but I knew that would take longer. So I'm on the phone with the insurance company, I kid you not, and this little car pulls up, window rolls down, and this teenage girl inside says, hey, do you guys need a jump? Yeah, do you have cables? Yeah. Bless you. And then she said, can we have your parking spot? Now, I don't care how God shows up. And so she pulled the car up, we got the jump cables out, and the car started right up, and we drove off, and she got her parking spot. Plus $20 for Starbucks coffee, because, you know, you've got to take care of people too. But it's just very cool how God shows up. And I think within our Advent series, if I can help us to realize that, is just to always be looking for those times when God does that. He shows up for us. Before we go any farther, June, I think we have some presentations.
Every year we like to kind of give a little thank you to some of the people that help in the around the sidelines at church all year long. And so we've got a few gifts here. Joanne's going to help me deliver them. We've got one, of course, for Pastor Mike. One. Cheryl is a Sunday school teacher. Maybe they can come up here. Sure. does the PowerPoint and
Donna loves being in the background so much that it's really hard to get her up in front of everybody.
Well, that was hard for her to
get up. Make sure you all see her standing there.
Nothing would happen without
her. Kelly and Britta, since they came from the same household, they share.
Donna, they won't let me be a faculty. Church, you take them away from family time, and we know that, so very thankful for that. At this point, I think we'll have the ushers come forward, and we'll take our offering together, and then... we're going to go to the Advent first. That's right, my bad. We'll have the Advent teams come up and do that, and then we'll have our offering.
We celebrate the announcement of the coming King and the greatness of God's
I'll ask Josh to come forward. And if you're visiting with us today, let me just remind you that the only thing we're going to ask you to put into the offering plate this morning is the white card that you filled out so we can have record of you. Our time of worship for giving is for those of us that call Zion our church home and our family. So we'll just invite you to do that. I'll say a brief word of prayer, and then we'll have the ushers go ahead and collect the offering. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the opportunity we have this morning to come before you and to return to you a small token of our appreciation for your gifts. We pray these things in your name. Amen. Watch over them, protect them. We just thank you so much for the fact that we do have a warm place where we can meet, and just ask that you keep us safe throughout the day. We pray, Father God, for those that aren't with us this morning for whatever the reason, and ask that you would just watch over them, guide them, protect them, encourage them in their lives. And I think especially of those right now in our area who are struggling financially, that you would just continue to provide for them. We pray for those that are struggling relationally, especially during this Christmas time, that you would just encourage them, that you would send people their way to be Jesus in the skin, to show them what you're about. Father, we pray as we go now to this time of worship and to the program and worship you through the story of John 3:16 and the songs that we sing. We just ask that you would be pleased and honored by what you hear from our hearts. We acknowledge to you that oftentimes our worship is built around superficial things, around external things, not of the heart. So we just ask that you would be pleased by what you see in our heart. And then, Father, we pray as you taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you. May be seated as we begin our time of I haven't asked permission for this from Linda, but I'm going to go ahead and do it anyway. And that is, one of the things we do here at Zion as far as worship is that we allow you the freedom to either stand during songs or sit for whatever you're doing as far as worship. So there will be some times when we ask the congregation to sing along, and we invite you to have that freedom to stand and worship here together. So, John 3:16, the way to go.
To have to sleep in a cardboard box under the bridge again. There was a blizzard coming, and it was so cold. They started walking and saw a policeman around the corner. Hesitantly, the boy walked up to him.
Well, all the shelters are pretty full, and some of them aren't even suitable for two boys such as yourselves. I'll tell you what, I'm going to walk to the house with you to the house. When I get there, you're to ring the door. You're going to knock on the door. A nice old lady will answer, and she does. Say, John 3:16.
And so they walked. They hadn't gone too far when the policeman stopped. He pointed to a big white house and sent the boys to the door. The boys walked up the steps and knocked on the door, and a lady answered.
Come in, boys. Here, you can have a seat in the rocker and you can sit at the stool. The fire is nice and warm.
Thank you.
young boys that John 3:16 was the greatest love story ever told. She told them about Mary and Joseph and how the angel came to Mary and told her that she had been chosen to give birth to the Son of God. And then she went on to tell them about the first Christmas.
And now it came to pass in those days, there went out a decree from Peter
Thank you. And an angel of the Lord stood by them, and the glory of the Lord shone about them. And they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them,
not ready yet.
Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy.
He shall be to all people, for there is born to you.
For there is born to you in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord, and this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was an angel of multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying,
glory to God in the highest and peace among men.
Thank you.
the babe laying in the manger. And when they saw it, they made known concerning the saying that was spoken to them about the child. And all that heard it wondered at the things which were spoken unto them by the shepherds. So Mary kept all these sayings, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, even as it was spoken unto them.
I'm not sure I understand all of it, but well, But John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Changing, always there, always powerful, always with us, wherever we are. So loved. So loved unconditionally. Knowing my weaknesses, knowing my failures, knowing how selfish I can get, knowing how I tend to demand my own way time after time after time, but he loved. For God so loved the world. Every nation, every culture, every ethnic group, every addict, every pedophile, every terrorist, every Muslim, every addict, but most importantly, me. For God so loved the world, me. For God so loved the world that He gave without compulsion. He gave knowing that his gift would be rejected by some, ignored by others, and misused and abused by other people. But he gave knowing that that gift would never, ever be returned to him in the way that he gave to us. His one and only Son. His pride and joy. His, when Jesus was baptized, God said, "This is my Son in whom I am well pleased." And there's not one of us in this room that don't long for that or don't desire to hear that from our dads. To say, "I'm pleased with you." He gave his only Son, fully God, so that we can understand completely what God was like. And yet fully man, so that we know that God understands us. He understands our feelings. He understands our failures. He understands those times that we're worried, that we're afraid. That whoever, regardless of intellect, regardless of financial stability, regardless of our past, whoever believes in him. That's the only requirement. The only requirement is that we believe. That we believe, first of all, that he loves us. That we believe he forgives us. And then we believe, and maybe most importantly, that we need a Savior. Shall not perish. Shall never die. The fear of death has been removed. The question of our destiny is no longer in question. Paul writes and he says, "O death, where is your sting? Where is your victory?" Death has been defeated by the very love of Jesus Christ. But have eternal life. Live forever. No more sickness. No more cancer. No more death. No more worry. Because the light that we found when we first learned about him is the light that travels with us throughout life, throughout death, throughout the grave, until finally we are joined together with him in his arms for all of eternity. That is the same verse that many of you have said, that I've said. But if we really thought about Christmas means, because Christmas is about John 3:16. I'd like you to stand together as we close. And I want you to say this verse one more time. You've already done it. I heard you all rattle it off. We're going to say it one more time. According to the Scripture. Thinking about what it means. For God so loved the world. That he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Isn't that a great promise? Can we, as we close, just sing the chorus of the Christmas carol? Just follow after me.
Now to him who is able to his plan through his power in each of our lives. To him who is able to do far above and beyond all that we could ask or imagine. To him be all the praise and all the honor, all the glory. And all God's people said, Amen.